Dear students, today I'll discuss with you about the sixth Guru, Guru Har Rai Ji. Guru Har Rai Ji was born at Kirtpur Sahib, the town which was founded by the sixth Guru, Guru Har Gobind Ji. On 30th January 1630, he was born at Kirtpur and he was married to Bibi Sulakhni Ji, the daughter of Daya Rai. Guru Har Rai's father was Baba Gurditta Ji and his mother was Raj Kaur. His wife's name was Sulakhni and from her he had two sons, Ram Rai, the elder one, and the Guru Har Krishan Ji, the younger one. According to a famous historian, Swarup Das Bhalla, who wrote Mahima Prakash, Baba Gurditta was the father of Har Rai, Raj Kaur was his mother, Sulakhni was his wife, to whom were born the two sons, that is Ram Rai and Guru Har Krishan. Guru Har Gobind was blessed with five sons, Baba Gurditta Ji, Baba Surajmal, Baba Ani Rai, Baba Atal and Guru Tegh Bahadur Ji. Atal Rai, Ani Rai and Gurditta died during the lifetime of their father. Surajmal was not interested in the worldly affairs. Guru Tegh Bahadur Ji was not prepared to have a responsibility of the Guruship. Baba Gurditta had two sons, Dhirmal and Har Rai. The elder son Dhirmal was deceitful and disloyal and had been conspiring with the enemy against the Sikh establishment. Har Rai alone was considered as the next guru, the seventh guru, by the sixth guru, Guru Har Rai Ji. In the last week of February 1644, Guru Har Gobind, as per the Sikh customs, seated Har Rai on the throne of the Guruship. Guru Har Rai maintained the traditions that Guru Har Gobind had laid for the spread of Sikhism. He was invariably accompanied by his armed people, but no conflict with the ruling powers took place during his time. As Kirtpur was in the hills and out of the Mughals' way, Guru Ka Langar remained the key factor in the social transformation that Sikhism had started. He did not compose any hymns of his own. He discoursed daily on the bani of his predecessors. Guru Har Rai's Guruship of the seventh year played a significant role in guiding the Sikh community through the tense period following the hostilities between the Sikhs and the Mughals in the time of the sixth Guru, which had resulted in the shifting of the Guru's abode from Amritsar to Kirtpur Sahib. Earlier, the Guru used to be in the Amritsar Sahib, but now he shifted his seat to the Kirtpur Sahib. He kept a strong contingent of 2,200 cavalry ready for any eventuality. He took precautions to avoid as far as possible any clash with the Mughals. Kalyan Chand, the Raja of Kalur, was killed in 1635. His son Tara Chand tried to avenge his father's death, but only with a partial success. The continued absence of the Guru from Amritsar gave rise to various misgivings. The hostility of the disappointed claimants to Guruship was also a hindrance in the smooth spread of Sikhism. The Meenas claimed Harji to be the next Guru of the Guru Nanak's throne. Harmandir Sahib was under their control and various masands also joined them. The situation therefore was delicate and challenging. The Guru faced it with rare courage. He avoided open conflict with the government or with any other social religious organization so that he might be able to pursue his spiritual mission undisturbed and unhampered. After a brief stay at Kirtpur Sahib, the Guru again took his travels. He first visited Ropat, where he was warmly received by the Sikhs led by Bhai Binju, Bhai Binda, Bhai Gajar, and Bhai Kariya. From Ropat, he reached Wadi Lehal. From Wadi Lehal, the Guru reached Hariya Bela. The Guru then reached Chautara Sahib, where from he proceeded to Kartarpur via Jalandhar. The Kartarpur city was founded by Guru Arjan Dev Ji in the Dwaba region in 1594. Baba Gurditta, Guru Arjan Dev Ji himself and his son and successor Guru Hargobind Ji came to stay here at different point of times. The marriage of their two sons, Surajmal and Tegh Bahadur, the sons of the sixth Guru, Guru Hargobind Ji, marriage took place here in Kartarpur. Guru Hargobind Ji also fought a battle here in April 1635 against the Faujdar of the Jalandhar. After the battle, Guru Hargobind went to Kirtpur, but his grandson Dhirmal and his descendants continued to stay at Kartarpur. Bhai Bhaktu, a dedicated Sikh of the Guru, died in 1708, or it is 1651 according to the Christian era. Here, and the Guru himself lit his pyre. In 1658, Guru stayed here along with his horsemen at the place is today commemorated by a Gurdwara named Tali Sahib, after the tree under which the Guru reposes. The next important halt of the Guru was at Noor Mahal. Guru came here in response to the invitation of his devoted Sikh Pai Sukhiya. Chaudhary Sood of this place visited the Guruji. After Noor Mahal, Guruji visited the Puandra Sahib and was touched at the devotion of the people. From Puandra, the Guru reached Droli, now in Firozpur district. Sai Das, husband of sister of Mata Damodri. Mata Damodri was the one of the wives of the sixth Guru, Guru Hargobind Ji, lived at Droli, which was frequently visited by Guru Hargobind Ji. The eldest son of Guru Hargobind, Baba Gurditta, was born at Droli. So Guru Har Rai Ji had a relationship here at Droli. Bhai Roop Chand, Bhai Kripal, Bhai Bidhi Chand, and other devoted Sikhs came to visit the Guruji. Bhai Gurdas and Bhai Tara, the grandson of Pai Belo, and Pai Behri, the son of Pai Punderi, served the Guruji devotionally here. From Droli, Guruji proceeded to Pai Rupa, a village founded by the parents of Rupa, Sadhu and Suti, at the instance of the sixth Guru, Guru Hargobind Ji. From village Bhai Rupa, the Guruji visited the different places and stayed at village Madi, where he got a well dug to provide potable water to the people. Then Guruji reached Nathana, where Guru Hargobind Ji had fought a battle with the Mughal forces in 1534. Here Kala and Karam Chand, sons of Mohan and leading figures of Sidhu Brar clan, came to express their devotion to the Guru and ask for the blessings. They told how they were maltreated by the Kaudas and the Bullers headed by Jait Pirana or Zaid Pirana, who threatened even to evict them from the village Mehraj. They were sure that Kauras and Bullers would listen to the Guru. The Guru called Jet Pirana and told him not to harass the Sindhu brats because they did not behave, want to fight on the basis of tribal considerations which were against the very spirit of brotherhood of the land. With the Guru's intervention, reconciliation was brought about between the brats and the Kauras and the Bullers. From Manthana, the Guruji reached Mehraj in response to the invitation of its people, especially Kala, the Chaudhary of the village. One day, Kala presented his nephew, Sandali, and Phool, whose father had been killed in the battle during the time of Guru Hargobind Ji. Phool, who was then 5 years old, and in the instance of his uncle, patted his own naked belly like a drum in front of the Guru. When asked why he did so, Kala explained that the boy was hungry and wanted something to eat. The Guru blessed the boy. You shall become a great and famous and wealthy. The seeds of your descendants shall drink water as far as Jamuna. They shall have the sovereignty for many generations and be honored in proportion as they serve the Guru. Phool had 6 sons, from the eldest of whom, namely Tilok Singh, the Raja of Naba, and Jin descended, and Phool's second son, Ram Singh, sired the Maharaja of Patiala. These 3 were known as Phool ke Raja, or the Rajas of the Phulkia state. Next important place was at Majhe ki Madi in the Malwa area. Here the Guru initiated Sangetia into Sikhism. Bhai Sangetia was a trader by profession and supplied the ghee, pure ghee, to the far off places. After initiation, he was given a new name, Bhai Feru. Bhai Feru was blessed with the title of Lord of the Guru Kalangar. He established his dera on the Multan Lahore road, where Guru Kalangar was served 24 hours every day. From Majhe ki Madi, the Guruji returned to Kirtpur Sahib. He left Kirtpur for Pihewa and Thaneshwar. He also paid brief visits to Samrala, Sanyal, Jaswal, Bhaike, Dosanj, and Palahi. After a short stay at Palahi, the Guru paid visit to Hadiabad, Kartarpur, Baba Bakala, Amritsar, and Goindwal. Dara Shikho, the eldest son of Shah Jahan, visited Guruji and took his blessings. Guruji reached Srinagar via Galotia, Sialkot, in 1660, and stayed in the Hap Bazaar, Srinagar. Bibi Saraswati, the mother of Pai Fera and Piraga, did her best to make the stay of the Guruji comfortable. Makhan Shah, the Lubana trader, Pilia Makhu Chand, and other devoted Sikhs also came to visit the Guruji. Among them was Aru Ram. Aru Ram was the father of Kirpa Ram Dutt, who later led a delegation of Kashmiri Brahmins to the court of the Guru Tegh Bahadur Ji, the 9th Sikh Guru. From Srinagar, the Guruji went to Matan and Martand, and then he reached Mota Tanda, where Makhan Shah lived. From here, he visited Akhnur and reached Jammu, where the local Masand Bhai Kana visited Guruji with the Sangat. The Guru made brief halts at Ramgarh, Kiri, Samba, and Pathankot, and he came back to Kirtpur Sahib. The Guru took care that the Masands were not unduly encouraged, and the Sikhs were encouraged to have a direct link with the Guruji instead of a mediator. Guruji wanted to have a direct link with his Sikhs. The most striking achievement of the Guru in the field of spread of Sikhism was the raising a new organization. Guru Har Gobind had appointed his eldest son Bhai Gurditta to streamline the missionary work. Baba Gurditta had established a network of missionary centers far and wide called Tue. Guru Har Rai Ji established 3 fresh missionary centers, each bearing the name of Bakshish, that is grace. Eminent Sikhs under the leadership of Sutra Shah, Sangetia, and Bhagat Gir were appointed to run these missionaries centers. In view of Bhagat Gir's dedication to the cause of the Guru, people called him by the name of Bhagat Bhagwan. The Guru appointed him in charge of the missionary work in the east, where he, along with his followers, established as many as 360 centers. Sutra Shah took upon himself to preach Sikhism in and around Delhi. Another center was established in the Lama area between the Bias and the Ravi. Bhai Feru was made the organizer of this area. Bhai families of Kathal and Bagdiyan were made responsible for the missionary work in the land between Jamuna and the Satluj. In Guru Har Gobind's time, there were 29 Sikh centers outside Punjab in central, north, western, and southern parts of the subcontinent. As the organizational network widened, certain Masands and Manjidars began to act independently and, in quite a number of cases, took liberty to exploit the innocent people instead of preaching a virtuous life in the light of the Guru's teachings. The establishment of regular and systematic contacts with the Sangats outside Punjab remained a problem. The Guru faced many problems in achieving his aims. First among these was that the government was hostile to the spread of Sikhism, that is the Mughal Empire. Secondly, Dhir Mal and Ram Rai were bent upon opposing the evolution of the Sikh faith. And lastly, and most of the Masands had become self-seekers, self-centered, and self-assuming. Dara, the eldest son of the Mughal Emperor Aurangzeb, developed a good relations with the sixth Guru, Guru Har Rai Ji. Because of the medicine that he saved his life, he also shared many principles of Sikh faith, which were nearer to the principles of Sufism. According to Jadunath Sarkar, the famous historian, Dara paid many visits of respect to the Guru as a part of his devotion to the sons and the Dravesh, although the Guru was 15 years younger than the prince. On way to Lahore, Dara visited Goindwal on 1st July 1658 and met Guruji, who had been there in response to the invitation of the descendants of the Guru Amar Das Ji. According to Dr. Trilochan Singh, Dara might have also visited Guruji because he wanted to meet Mata Nanki and Baba Tegh Bahadur on his way to Amritsar. During his meeting with the Guru, Dara asked for the assistance. The Guruji advised him to go to Lahore and gather an army and win the allies. Dara left Goindwal on 1st July 1658, and Aurangzeb reached Satluj nearly 2 months after the meeting between Dara and the Guru. Aurangzeb crowned himself on 21st July 1658. And made a move to the Punjab after the coronation. Bahadur Khan was the first general of Aurangzeb to attack Dara's army at Ropard on 5th 1658. Dara Shikoh fled away from Lahore on 18th August 1658. On the next day, Aurangzeb took possession of Lahore. Was a strategic measure. Guru Har Rai retired to the village Galoti in the district Sialkot and then proceeded to Kirtpur Sahib. A shrine, the Galoti, still commemorates Guru Har Rai's stay in the village during the rainy season of 1659. Some of the closest advisors of the emperor, like Mirza Raja Jai Singh, spoke very high of the Guru and their teaching. Even then, emperor was not convinced unless and until he met the Guruji. And to this effect, he sent the ambassador with a letter to the Guruji, summons him to presence in the Delhi. Guru decided to send his eldest son, Ram Rai, to the Mughal court. And Aurangzeb asked Ram Rai to explain the hymn of the Guru Nanak Dev Ji in the Guru Granth Sahib. That is Mitti Musalman Ki Pede Pe Kamyar. The verse only gives Guru Nanak's theory that the soul of man leaves the body and does not remain in the grave as a faith belief till today. The graves of poor men are often dominated by the potter for the clay to make pots, while the fate of the soul is known only to the God. Out of cowardice, Ram Rai said that it is a mistake, written mistake, clerical mistake, and the word Musliman, it is not Musliman, it is a Beiman, meaning a person without faith. When Guruji came to know about this, Guruji disinherited his son, and Guru refused to see even Ram Rai's face. Ram Rai begged for forgiveness and personally visited his father at Kirtpur Sahib, but he could not win back his father's confidence. He went to Lahore in the hope of persuading the Guru through the Sodhis and the Sangat of Lahore to accept him back. Guru Har Rai sent the Hukumnama to the Sangat of Lahore to disown Ram Rai and not to make him any offerings. Ram Rai even requested his uncle Tirmal to interfere on his behalf, but Guru could not be convinced. On 23rd September 1661, he appointed his second son, Guru Har Krishan Ji, as his successor and passed away on 6th October 1661, Ram Rai turned hostile to the 8th Guru and the 6th seat of authority. In due course of time, like his uncle Dhirmal founded his separate seat, he also founded his separate seat. Thank you very much.